flowers and roses, they know that a particular time in the season you have to cut the roses back because there becomes a little stick on the end of them that are basically dead. And if you don't remove the dead part, then the entire rose won't bloom. All right. Oh, stay with me on today. It makes sense. And every branch that bears fruit, he purgeth it. And it may bring that it may bring forth fruit. More fruit. More fruit. God wants the most out of you to come out. The best of you to come out. More. 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 Continuously making you over. Continuously promoting you to new levels. Sing with me on this morning. Larger the promotion, the larger the demon. Oh, I'm teaching you on today. Oh, when you was down here, you used to mess with the old demons. But when God begins to promote you up, you get even sophisticated demons. Oh, demons with strategy. Sing with me on this morning. Hallelujah, God, Jesus. Satan is always attacking you because he knows the greatness that's going to come from your life.
Amen.
Stay with me on this morning. I wouldn't let nobody make a fool out of me. Hallelujah, Jesus. Well, I did give you a little bit of, not really a tap on the hand, but I encourage you a little bit. And now that I've encouraged you to do the right thing, now I'm going to preach to you a little bit. If you don't mind me preaching, all work and no play is no fun. Amen. Hallelujah, God, on this morning. Harvest is the end of the world. Oh, the harvest is coming. When the husbandman, he goes on and he begins to groom the vineyard. Oh, it's called the harvest of the world. Jesus is coming, children of God. For the Bible declares in the book of Revelations, the 14th chapter, and the Bible declares, and the Bible declares, and the Bible declares, John looked, and lo, and behold, he saw a lamb that stood on the mountain of Sinai, and with him 144,000. Stay with me on this morning. Having his father's name in their forehead. This is the number that are of the 12 tribes of Israel. Well, in the last day to come, you're going to look around and you're going to see a baby lamb standing on a mountain. And behind that baby lamb will be 144,000 of God's chosen tribe of Israel. Stay with me all today. And the Bible declares, and John heard a voice from heaven. It was the voice of many waters, the voice of a great thunder. It was the voice that was inside of the 144,000. And the Bible declares, all who had not defiled themselves with women, they were included in that 144,000. See, keeping yourself clean will get you some reward. Keeping yourself humble to God will get you some reward. You got to serve God with all. It was the voice of many waters, the voice of great thunder, and the men who had not defiled themselves with women. And in their mouth, the Bible says, no guilt was found. That means that in their mouth, see, the Bible declares, it's not what goes into a man that defiles him, but it's what that comes out of a man that defiles him. And when you defile your temple with all that messed up stuff, it begins to put in things in your mind. You begin to start thinking the wrong way. Then your heart and your temple, it becomes defiled. And then it manifests itself with wrath, anger, envy, and strife. You begin to scream at people. You begin to yell and holler at folks. So it's not that what goes in that defiles you, but it's the manifestation of what's in that defiles your mind, your mindset. And then the enemy starts telling you, you know you a loser. You know you can't break out of this one. Oh my God, Jesus. Then the angel said with a loud voice, and fear God and give him glory, is what the angel said. For the hour has come. I'm talking about Revelation. Worship him that made heaven. And the 12th verse. For the seed shall be prosperous. And the vine, it shall give forth her fruit. And the ground shall give forth her increase. And the heaven and the heavens shall give their due. And I will cause the remnant of this people to possess all things. Say it with me on this morning. Hallelujah, God. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, you can ask what you shall will, and it be done unto you. This is why some of us are not getting the answer from God. Because the word, it has to abide in us. The truth has to abide in us. If you abide in God, and he abide in you, then can you ask what you may? And my people who are called by name, God's calling you, Brother Eric. And my people were called by my name, Sister Sonia. God's calling you. And my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and seek me, my kingdom, and all of my righteousness. Yes.